Hey Kev, thanks for speaking to us today on the eve, of course, of your 100th Test match. First of all, I actually want to take you back to the beginning of your England career. I know it was one day cricket, but the challenge that you faced going into that arena, did that set you up, do you think, for your Test career? Did it make you feel that you could perform at the highest level?
It definitely tested my character in terms of technique. Test cricket was only going to test my technique. It certainly tested my character. And I think that it gave me a lot of confidence going into my Test career, knowing that I could deal with what I dealt with in South Africa. And nothing's been as hard as that ever since. So it was a good start, and luckily I came through it.
And that belief, obviously, Lords against Australia. I was actually in the crowd that day, and when you came to the crease, there was kind of a change, not just in the game and the excitement in the crowd, but it felt like something was changing in English cricket. Were you completely oblivious to that and just enjoying the moment?
Absolutely. I mean, it was my Test debut, and we got hammered in that Test match, and it was one of those where people thought, goodness, this is going to be another drilling by Australia in England. So I was totally oblivious to all that kind of stuff. I was just concentrating on enjoying my life, enjoying my cricket, and trying to make the most of an opportunity.
Did you feel completely ready for it at that stage?
I felt ready, yeah, because I'd done a lot of prep. I'd done a lot of county cricket. I'd played a lot of first-class cricket. I'd played quite a bit of one-day international cricket. And I felt that, it was time to test my technique in Test cricket.
And obviously the series was a phenomenal one. Everyone talks about that century at the Oval. When you were engaged in that battle, Brett Lee's pretty much trying to knock your block off, bowling at almost 100 miles an hour. Was that what you were living for? Do you think this is the ultimate high, you know, this is where it's at?
Absolutely, yeah, that was exactly where it was. I mean, I was with Brett on Saturday night, and we were talking about the Oval and talking about that Ashes series. And it's just great to reminisce and go over things. When you're in the bubble, when you're in the zone, you're actually nowhere else other than focused and, on the job you're doing. You're not thinking about everything else that everybody else is thinking about because it's such a high-pressure environment. But it was a great, great day, and it was just awesome to contribute to what was an incredible summer.
And I know club cricketers have their moments of euphoria, and you have it on the village greens and all this kind of stuff, but the moment you went for the first time to three figures in your England shirt, I mean,
special.
Can you describe it?
Yeah, it was extremely special. I mean, I was under a lot of pressure coming into that series. I know a lot of people had said, well, he's flashy, he's got 50s in this series. This is a huge knock. And Warnie knocked me over in the first innings, trying to whip him through mid-wicket. And in testament to my character, I continue to whip him in the second innings and just to continue just believing in what I practice. I think I'm a great believer in making sure that I do the hard yards in training, and I will practice specifics until I can't practice them anymore. And if it's meant to be in a game, it's meant to be in a game, and that's how I've lived my life, and that's how I've certainly gone about my cricketing career.
Is that one of the big things for you across? I mean, the fact that you've now played and will play 100 Test matches, could you have ever dreamt that was possible, first and foremost, but also that belief that you took into international cricket? I think some people just don't understand, actually, that you had that and that was such a strength for you.
I mean, believing that I'm going to play 100 Test matches is probably something I'll never do, because I don't see myself as some cricketer who can play 100 Test matches. And the belief that I've taken into what I've done has been instrumental and key to a lot of success, because I've never ever stood back or stood away or shied away from a hard training session. I've always put myself in uncomfortable positions in training and in practice, and away from the game as well, where nobody sees the hard work that I've done. Because I think that's what builds your confidence and backs you in the tough times.
Now we're on the verge of this 100th Test match. Can you pick a few moments that stand out, certainly innings-wise? I mean, Colombo has mentioned that was obviously right up there.
Yeah.
So what were your favourites?
Colombo last year was just a favourite because physically I didn't think I'd be able to get 100 in or bat that long in those conditions. South Africa last year, I mean, last year was pretty much right up there because South Africa at Headingley was a very emotional week for me, which I'll talk about when I'm finished. To have got those runs and to play the way that I played was pretty special. Mumbai in India on that wicket was a knock that I really enjoyed.
Well, he's got that in the empty space. sweeps in the air around the wicket. What a shot that is, what a shot. Now that's a scoop.
And an ouch, the drive. That's a fabulous shot. That's gone into the...
Well, he's lofted that on the off. Here comes the sweep shot. It's a big one.
Scoring my first Test 100 against South Africa at Lords was a special time. There's been quite a bit of good stuff.
Quite a few good ones.
It's just been an incredible journey, and I just feel so lucky to have been given the nod in 2005. And really humbled, but still so excited about putting on an England jersey. It's what dreams are made of, and I'm very, very lucky to do what I'm doing.
Well, that is obviously the big question. How far do you want to go? You know, what's still left to achieve for you? What dreams have you still got, and what targets, I guess, have you still got?
I'd love to get 10,000 test runs. I've got home and away hundreds against every nation, every major nation apart from South Africa. So I need to try and see if I can tick the South Africa away box in terms of test hundreds. There's 10,000 test runs, there's the 2015 World Cup. There's still quite a few things I'd like to achieve playing for England. And while I'm happy and everything's going well as it is at the moment, there's no need to worry about anything.
I was going to say, you seem pretty content in training as well. You seem in a good place at the moment. How much are you looking forward to the actual occasion, this first test of an Ashes series in Brisbane, but also receiving the honour as well as 100 appearances?
It'll be a great occasion. There's no better time to be playing a 100 test match in an Ashes series, in an Ashes opener here. And also as a team, we know that we can get better than where we played in the summer. And I think that's really encouraging. The experience that we've got in playing test cricket, the number of caps we've got in our dressing room, the experience of winning in Australia last time, and also knowing, thirdly, that we didn't play as well as we should have in England. I mean, we certainly didn't bat as well as we could have, but every single batter is in pretty good nick going into this first test match, so those are just really good signs for us as a team.
I just want to quickly touch on that moment when you put the wicket falls and you're walking out to the crease. Yeah. Do you still feel the same way you did, you know, for your first few test matches,
or is it completely... Waiting to bat?
Well, just as
waiting to bat, I do. Yeah. But as soon as the wicket falls, I'm on my job. I'm thinking about the ball, and I mean, I do my prep waiting to bat. I like to see what the bowler's doing, what the wicket's doing, how much it's swinging, how much it's seaming. And then, I just sit there and talk garbage. And as the wicket falls, then I switch on. Yeah.
And the innings you mentioned, they've all been, I guess, those similar to the Oval, the first one, 05, those moments where so much is at stake, the stakes are high, you know, the adrenaline's pumping, you seem to deliver when it's really required. I mean, that must be something that makes you particularly proud, I guess.
Absolutely. I want to be probably remembered as somebody who scored runs for England when the team needed them, and in situations where it looked like we faced defeat. And I played innings that assisted in us actually winning test matches. I think that would be a really nice way to finish. And hopefully there's quite a few more of those left in me.